TheoTrade. This is Don Kaufman. August 10th, 2022. Just moments to go to the cash close here on this Wednesday afternoon. S&P is soaring to the upside on what is some cooler inflationary readings than any of us expected. The CPI coming in a little lighter. The S&Ps loved it and exploded to the oh-so-critical level of none other than 4211. For those of you that do not remember, it's exactly the weekend update level that we discussed in detail. People, we are on it. That is the gravity point. We have actually exploded to the 4211. But I have to actually ask the question, how are markets reacting to this cooling inflation? And of course, on the surface, you look like a knee-jerk reaction. You're like, well, hey, Don, look at the S&Ps. They're exploding up, you know, some 2%. The Nasdaq's up just shy of 3%. Why do you have to ask how the market is reacting to cooling inflation? Because I'm going to tell you right now, there's a lot more going on right now than meets the eye in this marketplace. Stability is anything but in the marketplace. If you look at the volatility and the volatility is falling, I'm telling you, be careful with that notion. It's the first time in quite some time we've actually had a VIX that's back under the 20 region. You got to come back here into the, late March, early kind of April, time frame to see a VIX that's down, you know, into the 20 region. And I say, listen, how the market's reacting is anything but certain at this point. The one thing that is certain, we came right back to the happy place for the marketplace, 4211. And again, I talk about this stuff incessantly because for the most part, you had to come up and you had to kind of, if you will, check that box. 4211 is an absolutely critical inflection point for the entire S&P. And when I term it's a gravity point, I don't want you to think about support and resistance because it's not. It's just the happy place for risk. There's a huge amount of previous open interest that existed in and around this level. We come back, we gravitate to it, do a little dance, make a little love, but breaking off this will be the next major move for the S&Ps. So let's get down to business. There is the closing bell. Let's get down to business with a little bit beyond the fact that we're at 4211. Why the cause for some concern about how markets reacting to cooling inflation? For that, cruise over here to the CME FedWatch tool. In fact, I'm even going to refresh it because I found this not just interesting. I thought it was pretty shocking. So if you look at the current rate, and again, I'm going to be very, very specific here. We are looking at 225, 250. That's the current rate. Right down here, you're looking at about a 56%. 56% probability of what? That's a 50 basis point hike. Over here, it's about a 43% probability. Again, of what? 75 basis point hike. So we don't have odds just yet on a full 1 point or 100 basis points. The reason I found this interesting is it's not at all what I would have expected. The S&P is just ripped by 2%. It just ripped up by 2%. That's about as ambiguous as it gets. That's why I said, you know, how are markets actually reacting to cooling inflation? That's a good question, because if you looked at this yesterday, there's about a 66.5% probability of a 75 basis point hike. So that's cooled off. But for the most part, what are you? You're a coin flip away, whether it's going to be 50 basis points or 75 basis points. Okay, frankly, in my estimation, that ain't bullish. Okay, not bearish really either, but we're going to hike either 50 basis points or 75 basis points. Listen, the bottom line is they're still going to hike. Now, let me show you some other very, again, what I would term ambiguous readings. Look at the bond market today. It's all over the place. The bonds initially spiked to 144, reversed all the way back down to 142. Again, monumental moves in a short period of time in bonds. But if the bonds start selling off, wouldn't that be indicative of rates going a little bit higher? It's not what you would expect with cooling inflation, because inflation is like, you know, what did it come in? CPI today came in at like 8.5%. It was 9.1%. You know, again, I don't want to spend all day talking about what the inflation numbers were. It's neither here nor there. Here's the bottom line. The Fed's looking for 2% inflation. Where are we right now? We're not even in the same ballpark. We're not even playing the same sport. not even in the same universe in terms of inflation. And people are like, it's subsiding. It could subside, but inflation is entrenched in the environment that we're presently in. And we're going to still see a tremendous amount of risk based on that. The interesting area, though, was the wild reversal inside of the bond market, the wild reversal inside of the notes. By the way, both the notes and the bonds, this thing just, it did monumental size in here today. I mean, just huge volume after a couple of days of doing absolutely nothing. Notes took off in terms of volume. Now, of course, everybody looks back at the VIX, and the VIX, it subsided under 20. Last time we saw that was late March, early April, when we had the VIX under 20. That did not end well. Nevertheless, volatility has kind of collapsed in this marketplace. Listen, don't get off your game. As I said, we're at a key kind of, pivotal point inside of the S&Ps being back at the 4211. But lo and behold, not much has actually changed. Like, the Fed policy, that's not going to change. Well, they have actually made some headway in terms of inflation. Listen to me, the Fed has done nothing in terms of headway inflation. The inflation actually came off predominantly because of food and energy costs. The energy course, of course, came down substantially. So if you're looking at that headline number of about 8.5%, that is influenced by, of course, oil and food. Then, of course, there's another number came in at about 5.9% that extracts food and energy. That's still hot as can be. So what's really changed? Well, according to the FedWatch tool, very little. There's still that 50-50 argument. What's also kind of changed a little bit, all right? So the S&Ps popped to the upside, but the S&Ps went exactly to where we thought they would. It just needed a little bit of a catalyst. It was almost like this thing was, preordained to trade into 4211. I say this often, markets, again, they have to check certain boxes along the way. As I said, this 4211, we hit it. Now it's a gravity point. It's the next move off of this level that is going to make all the difference. And with that, I want to cruise over to the SPX, because one thing can actually be discerned very easily from the SPX. Yes, the markets popped to the upside. Yes, we have a decent expected move on the week. And that expected move was substantial on the week, specifically because of this CPI print. So we're just under about a $90 expected move for the week. Look where we presently are, right? Listen, we started the week, and I actually want to be very, very specific about levels here. We started the week down and around the 41.45 level. Okay, sold off a little bit, obviously, on Monday and Tuesday, just nominally. Monday was a nothing day. Tuesday, a little bit. We explode back to the upside. But we haven't done anything unusual. We haven't done anything astounding this week. So we had a big pop to the upside. Guess what? The upper edge of the expected move doesn't come till 42.33. Now, granted, we're only a hop, skip, and a jump away from that. We're 23 handles away. We may have to actually come up there, tag that box before reverting back to the 42.11. But lo and behold, the S&P's popping to the upside is of no surprise. The area of contention for me, though, is really this bond market. The bond market, there's such an ambiguous nature out of today's trading session that I'm telling you, it leaves me in a little bit of a lurch. Like, I have no comfort whatsoever in the S&Ps having exploded to the upside. And this is where, of course, everybody's like, is Don still bearish? Yeah, you better believe it. Okay. And the opportunity right now is isn't necessarily to run out and short. Let's actually see how we trade above or below this 42.11. Again, we're going to play a little bit of wait and see before we actually step in, try to allocate and take some more risk. I think the bond market is definitely sending a bit of a signal to the S&Ps, which is not being read by most traders. Granted, volatility is down, but let me show you something about volatility, because that's anything but straightforward. If you look at VIX right now, and VIX is trading at 1974, to go out 41 days, if you go out 41 days, what's the at-the-money option in here? The at-the-money option is all the way up here, somewhere around like 23.5, meaning that the VIX being down to 19, the options are not pricing the VIX down at the 19 level. The options in VIX 41 days out are pricing, this marketplace closer to like 23.50. And if you go a little further out in time, if you look at the options out in the 70-day expiration here, you're looking at a marketplace that's still about 25 half, somewhere in that neighborhood. And by the way, if you will, just cruise over to the volatility futures. It's a little easier to look at the volatility futures. We'll cheat for a second. 42 days out, the VIX is actually priced at about 23.67. 70 days out, they're pricing for 25.45. And the reason I'm bringing that up is like everybody thinks like the VIX is an easy trade. Look, let's get bullish on the VIX. But the VIX is already pricing reversion back up. Okay. So when you look at the S&Ps, you see one picture and you're like, whoa, markets are kind of just exploding to the upside because it's cooling inflation. But there's a lot of signs in the marketplace that would completely disagree with that notion. I mean, yeah, again, the bond market did anything, okay, but what I would have anticipated for today's trading session. I mean, the yield curve kind of like, you know, less inversion than it was. We can look at the 2 and the 10 till we're blue in the face. But again, today's move, okay, is not what I would have anticipated, not about the S&Ps, not what I would have anticipated for the bond market. Okay, the dollar makes a lot of sense, but then the dollar started to turn around and rally back up. Oil got clobbered earlier in the session, only to finish up a dollar. Again, this is anything but certain. There's a little bit of chaos in the trade. We got to wait for us to actually break above or below this 42.11. Again, coming off of a gravity point is absolutely critical. We're going to look for opportunities literally in the next 24 to 48 hours of trade, the remainder of the week. Speaking of the remainder of the week, we still have not hit the upper or lower edge of the expected move. And one thing I want to leave you with on this evening's video is, you know, you listen to the evening's video is like, hey, Don doesn't seem to have a great feel for the S&Ps. There isn't a great feel for the S&Ps. Again, they just checked the box, the 42.11. It had nothing to do with CPI. Cooling inflation didn't have the effect, okay, on the, you know, on those Fed fund futures that I thought they would. All right. The bonds, they're all over the place. Again, there's still risk being splattered throughout your screen. In fact, you know, when was the last time you actually took a look at the VVIX? Okay, I'll come back over to the SPX in a second, but when was the last time you looked at the VVIX? You realized the volatility index actually bid higher today. So you got traders buying VIX options in an S&P that's up some 2%. Okay, trust nothing you see on your screen right now. Again, today's entire move is brought to you by 42.11. Ultimately, CPI was just throwing a match in a pool of gasoline. We needed that rip to the upside. Now, people, now we're going to trade. Again, the remainder of the week. The upside edge, as I said a moment ago, was about 42.32. Nevertheless, there's still big boy risk priced in here. You have almost $50 of movement still priced into the SPX. People, still anybody's trading session, anybody's week. One last thing I did want to actually also leave you with here. Last week, we did not touch the upper or lower edge of the expected move. We have not had two consecutive weeks, okay, of not hitting edge of expected move this entire year. Effectively, what I'm saying is probability is with you right now to hit the upper edge of the expected move and or the lower edge of the expected move. Obviously, we're substantially closer to the upper edge of the expected move. We have not had, okay, a week go by, right, where we had a week where we didn't hit an edge of expected move and the subsequent week not hit hasn't happened throughout the course of the year. It doesn't mean it's not going to happen right now, but from a probability point of view, that's one that's fairly high probability of, again, hitting the upper edge of expected move. Clearly, that is going to be the more decisive move in here to the 42, 32, but never count out the downside. That's all the way down in and around, okay, the 40.58 level. You look at the S&Ps, you go, there's no way we can get down there, people. I'm telling you right now, okay, the move to 42.11 happened. We checked the box, okay? People, now we're ready to trade. Bonds are ambiguous as they've ever been. Yes, volatility is crushed, but that's just a function of we're through an announcement. Be careful. We did buy some volatility. That is, professional traders coming in and buying volatility specifically in the VIX. Going to be real curious to see the skew print. Skew has also been climbing in the backdrop of this. So somebody sees risk somewhere in this marketplace. I do as well. Thanks, everybody, for joining us here at TheoTrade. Have a wonderful evening. Bye-bye.